morning we sent you to vigil. Contemplate joining the Order of the Pelican. At this time, we have your answer. Before we can continue, though, I believe there is unfinished business.
Yes, Your Majesty. You know, some time ago, you went on a signed contract. The terms of this contract says it shall be terminated in the next
friends and kin in Atlantian. Long before there were masters defense, King said, if you want something done, find a white scarf. And it is said that the measure of a master of defense is that it should not be a surprise if they win, no matter who their opponent. Well, if you want something taken care of, find Rowan. She's probably already headed where she's needed anyway. No matter the task, she will succeed and she'll make it look easy. She is a fire and forget missile, as certainly as any master in the defensive champion does. She overcomes the steepest opposition and doesn't break a sweat. She came to our canton a decade ago and dove right in, made herself at home in this crowd of strangers, and then started making her home better. A year after arriving, she was organizing baronial pens in camp, the first of five times. While working a job with an insanely demanding schedule and straight up insane boss. A year after that, she was autocrating an event for her canton, still with the insane job. Being Woodmaster's baronial seneschal was a hard enough challenge, so she did it while in grad school, in the Czech Republic. Of course, autocrating a mirror is a huge undertaking, so she waited until she was just baronial seneschal. Taking that job on. She is a master of making the dream happen. She makes it look effortless, and she is my peer. Your Majesties, I can also speak for this lady. And I most heartily recommend her to you. She is my peer.
Is there a member of the Order of the Laurel to speak to this gentleman?
That honor is mine, Your Majesty, unless anyone objects.
I make art at home, where it's comfortable and quiet most of the time. I don't go out into the mud in the middle of the night to light torches or hangman or for set up visual tents for people. I don't autocrat events to where I have to answer even messages from many, 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 many people.
because when she sets up a camp, to walk into it is to be transported back in time into a beautiful place, full of friendship and camaraderie. And that is the best expression of art, the one that can be given to anyone. And she does it so well. She makes things that serve so many people. She makes banners that bring joy to hearts. She makes things and gives them away. And then she also makes things and makes sure that they're cared for. She stewards one of the largest dairies in the kingdom and all of its stuff. And she does it well. Your Majesty, this lady is not my peer. She is much better than that, and maybe someday when I get a little older, I will be as much of a peer as she is. I hardly recognize her.
You're a lady of the road. Speak.
Your Majesty, today I am the luckiest of duchesses, because that privilege is mine. The ladies of the rose are charged to watch for and encourage courtesy wherever we find it. I have long found it in Lady Rose. Her service comes almost always with a smile. She is reliable nearly to a fault. She is warm and welcoming, and a jewel in the crown of Atlantia. Master Nikolai has taught her well, and it is time that she joined the ranks of her peers. I commend her to you highly, and say that she is beyond doubt my peer.
A member of the Order of the Chivalry will speak on the candidate's behalf.
Hi, Sir Raymond de Rochelle. We bring word to our regal Falcon, Baron, the Master Till. Unto the Royal Majesties Atlantia does this night, Baron Rodrigo Falcon send greetings. It is with trust and surety I recommend to you in the ancient order, venerable order of the Pelican, Lady Rowan of Hawkridge. Strength and courage in adversity is worthless without perseverance. I have certainly witnessed Lady Rowan persevere with strength and courage. Knowledge and leadership cannot be properly applied to any task without understanding. I trust the word of Lord of Lady Rowan, and I have witnessed and benefited from her knowledge and leadership. Success in service can only be drawn from commitment. This kingdom has often witnessed Lady Rowan's commitment and has benefited greatly from her service to us. Your Majesties, you may rely on Lady Rowan's strength, courage, knowledge, leadership, and success as I have. You may trust her words and counsel as I have. Lady Rowan, you have long been my peer. You brought example in our society. Our kingdom needs peers like you. And I wish you success and happiness in your new station. I'm glad to know that others in the kingdom who don't know you as I do will be able to see you as I do. Your Majesties, I thank you for the opportunity to address your court and affirm the oath I gave the Almighty God, the Lord of the Lord, the Lord of the United States.
Lastly, we would hear from a member of the Order of the Pelican.
Your Majesty, to the populace of Atlantia, Master Nikolai has granted me one of my dearest wishes and allowed me to speak today for Lady Rowan. I would like to start off my words by saying Lady Rowan is my peer and has been for quite some time. Now that we've gotten that over with, I would like to say this woman has done the most monumental of jobs and done them with grace that is nothing short of amazing. She is the seneschal of Woodmaster's Hill. Do you hear the rending of garments,
the screams of agony. Do you hear any frustration coming from her office? No, and you won't. Because Rowan takes on this task like she takes on the task of sitting at an MOL table during Crown Tournament, where there is a lot of stress going on, but Rowan brings calm and the belief that we will get through this together, because she is there and she will stand by you like someone else stands the line with a fellow fighter, because that is how she serves. She is consistent, she is efficient, she will not let you have your back unguarded. She has sat at many a table with me at Crown Tournament, and it wasn't just because she was Nikolai's student, it was because she is Rowan. Trying not to forget anything. And whether she is sitting at the MOL tables, whether she is being the seneschal of Windmaster's Hill, or whether she is scrubbing goo off of the inside of a stove at an event at 11:30 at night, because it needs to be done, Your Majesties, she is there, because that is what Rowan does. She is a peer, Your Majesty. She is my peer. She is a Pelican, and I am that you are raising her to be part of our order this day. Thank you.
These words have been mighty. We have very deserved. Lord, His Majesty and I do feel you are very deserving. Is there a cloak for this gift?
There is. There's a cloak. It has bears her colors on the inside. And bears a pelican on the outside.
Now, on to you.
I know you have many presents.
Presence to all gentles far and wide. We have heard many reports, landing innumerable hours of service and fearless sacrifice given not only to stewardship of our lands and people, but to the known world by our well-beloved subject, Lady Rowan of Hawkridge. Thus are we minded to induct her into our Order of the Pelican by letters patent to bear the arms, her chevron, and sure and birth, in base, a bird migrant sergeant, with all rights, regalia, and honors, and duties here and there, for that all may know her worth. Done this second day of March, AS 53, at Kingdom Hearts and Sciences Festival, by our hand.
My speech aren't like this. If you ever have need of this, if you ever have need of our heart, our shelter, our advice, our friendship, whether we sit these thrones or not, this will come to your aid.
Congratulations. Just say,
get our
pelican out first.
That's
please. Her mistress, Rowan, newest member of the Order of the Pelican.
Is he not?